is Gourav. In this video, we will learn to calculate payback period. So let's get started. First of all, what is payback period? Payback period is actually the length of time that you will require in order to accumulate the total cash flows from an investment as equal to the total initial outlays. That is, for example, you had invested a sum of money in your business, supposedly rupees 10,000, and it is expected that you will receive rupees 2,000 annually from the same business. So you have to actually calculate the time period in which you will actually get back your rupees 10,000, which were your initial investment. So payback period essentially means the period in which you will be paid back all your initial investment through the cash flows from that same business. The main area is how to calculate the payback period. So here are three steps, the first of which is to calculate the total initial capital investment. This is essential because in order to calculate the payback period, the first thing that you need to know is the amount of investment that you had put in any particular business. Step 2 is to calculate annual expected after-tax cash flows, because this is also essential as this is the amount of cash inflows against your cash outflows which you had calculated in step 1. And the final step is to calculate the cumulative total of all the cash flows which you had calculated in step 2 and make sure that you end up at the time period where your cumulative total equals your initial capital investment. The time period that you will require to do that is known as payback period. So here we go, this is the first illustration. In this illustration, there is a project that requires 25,000 as initial investment and is expected to generate annual cash inflows of rupees 5,000 for the next 10 years. We are required to calculate the payback period for the said investment. Well, this is very easy because we know that there are altogether rupees 5,000 to be taken as cash inflows, and you have to accumulate that in such a sense that you get rupees 25,000. So it is quite evident that you will require 5 years to accumulate a total of rupees 25,000 which were your initial investment. So let's check out the solution. So the solution is 5 years, since 5,000 that you get every year will accumulate to rupees 25,000 in 5 years. So 5 years is your payback period. We'll jump over to one more illustration, this time a little typical. Here, a project requires 25,000 again, but this time the cash inflows are not constant. Rather, you have 5 different cash flows in the next 5 years. What we have to do is to calculate the payback period for the said illustration. So here's the solution. What you can do is you can plot the years in first column, cash flows in the second, and third column will be the cumulative cash flows. Years will be 1 to 5 as you have 5 years given in this problem. The cash flows have just been taken from the illustration, and the cumulative cash flow is just the cumulative total of all the cash flows as per the time period, as in till the first year you have received only 6,000, so the cumulative cash flow is 6,000. By the end of second year you have two amounts, you have 6,000 as well as 9,000, so the cumulative has gone to 15,000, and it goes to 22, 28 and 32 in the same manner. What we can do out of it is to find out where does rupees 25,000 which were my initial investment lies. As you can clearly see, it lies somewhere here in between year 3 and year 4. So this is quite evident that our payback period will be greater than 3 years but less than 4 years. So let's check out the solution. Our payback period will fall between year 3 and 4, that is already known. So our payback period will be at least 3 years, so we have taken 3. And then till the end of 3rd year, we had a total cumulative of 22,000. And our requirement were 25,000. So we have clearly fallen short of 3,000 rupees, which we expect to generate out of the fourth year. Since in the fourth year, we are generating a cash flow of 6,000 and we require only 3,000 for our payback period. So we will be requiring only half of the fourth year. So a payback period is actually 3.5 years. Finally, the advantages and disadvantages of payback period. Amongst the advantages, the most evident ones are that it is easy to compute as well as to understand, and it provides a quick estimate of profitability of a project, as it says which project is better. Obviously, a project with a lesser or a lower payback will be considered over a project which has a higher payback period. Amongst the disadvantages, the primary one to look after is the ignorance of time value of money. As you can clearly see, we have just summed up all the cash flows instead of doing their PVs, so we have clearly ignored time value of money concept. And second is that we have clearly ignored the cash flows that fall after the payback period, as we have ignored rupees 4000 here, because our payback period was achieved somewhere before the fourth year or before the end of the fourth year. So the fifth year and any cash flows thereafter will be clearly ignored. So this is one of the primary disadvantages of payback period. That's it. Thank you for watching this video. Do like this video and subscribe to our channel. See you. Bye.